Now, let's put in Vaunda's chart of accounts. You may well ask, what is the chart of accounts? Well, in the old days, the chart of accounts was the general ledger. Then you might ask, what is the general ledger? Well, as you can see, it's a book where each page in the book records a different item of income, expense, or asset that a company might have. For example, page one might be the page where you write down every event or every transaction where you earned video income. Page six might be the page where you write down every event or every transaction where you pay repair expense. And the entire book is the general ledger. When it comes to the computer, the general ledger is called the chart of accounts. And as you can see, here's Vaunda's chart of accounts, and here are the names of the accounts that we're about to type in. Every account has a name and a type. The type of account you choose is one of the preset choices from the pull-down menu. The name you can type in yourself. You can call the accounts anything you want as long as you recognize it. But we recommend that you write down the names as is shown here. The corresponding type will determine how it behaves. For example, it doesn't matter what you call cash and bank. You can name it cash and Chase Bank or bank account. But as long as you choose bank type of account to go with it, QuickBooks Online will know that that's the account that matches to your bank account, and you could possibly later import bank transactions or do bank feeds. Same thing with account receivable and account payable. They're special accounts. You don't have to name it accounts receivable. You could change the name to money customers owe us if you want to. But if you choose type accounts receivable, QuickBooks will know that this is the account, regardless of what you named it, this is the account that matches the customer's balances. Since this is the picture we will be copying from when we input the chart of accounts, I will be coming back to this picture, reading from it, then going to QuickBooks Online and recording the account on the list. If you like, you can pause the video at this picture and put in the rest of the accounts yourself. But here's the procedure we're going to follow. We're going to do these steps. First, we're going to delete any accounts that QuickBooks already put in. Then we'll put in Vaunda's accounts. We will use all capital letters in the name field. This is because we will more easily see which accounts we put ourselves. And if you can't delete an account because QuickBooks doesn't allow you, just leave it and we'll just put in ours. So we come back to the list so that you can see it, and we go to QuickBooks Online. Now in QuickBooks Online, in order to put in the chart of accounts, you have two choices. You could click the cog and you could click chart of accounts here, or you could come to the panel on the left and click accounting, chart of accounts. Now, you might not come directly to this screen. When you click chart of accounts, you might get a little green button that says, let's see your chart of accounts. Don't worry about that. Just click on that. Click on the little green button that popped up if it's your first time coming to your chart of accounts, and then you will see this list. Now, when you look at this list, maybe I should restore it down. When you look at this list, you will see QuickBooks already put this list as your chart of accounts. Don't take it personally. It does it for every company. QuickBooks is trying to help you by setting up a chart of accounts for you. And as you can see, here's the name of the accounts, and here's the corresponding type. Now, QuickBooks Online also has something called detail type that we don't have to deal with right now. You only need to know detail type if you have a very specific situation. And if you're in that situation, you will know which detail type to choose. In the meantime, we'll leave the default for whatever detail type comes up when we choose the account type when making the accounts. So now follow step by step. Let's delete whichever ones we can. Whichever ones we can't, we'll let go. Okay? So uncategorized asset, go to the left, click delete. Are you sure? Yes. Okay. It won't let you do it. Owner's investment, delete. Yes. It let you delete it. Oh, actually, it says now it's inactive. Okay. Owner's pay and personal expenses, delete. Yes. It tells you now it's inactive. Okay. Retained earnings, I know for sure it's not going to let you delete. Okay. Don't worry. Billable expense income, will delete. Yes. Okay. Now, it calls it inactive, and there is a way that I could show you later where you could reactivate an inactive account. But right now, let's just remove the ones that we don't need. Okay, it's already set up that way. Okay, let's delete this one. Let's delete all the ones we pause up. See, we can't delete that one either. What about this one? Delete? Yes. Okay. Let's go delete. Yes. Okay. It's not going to let you delete all of them, but you'll delete as many as you can and get practice deleting. So I'm going to pause the video and delete the remaining ones that QuickBooks allows me to delete, and I suggest you do the same. Now, if you do this properly, there should only be a few accounts left, and each of these accounts should be written in lowercase with just one capital letter, because those are the accounts that QuickBooks put. I realized I should have given you a tip before I asked you to shut the video and delete the rest. If you accidentally click in the wrong place and you are lost, just click the back button in your browser and you'll come back to where you were. For example, I know that some students accidentally click Run Report and they don't realize they click Run Report. Now you're lost. You're looking at this thing and you don't know what it is. Don't worry. Just hit the back button in your browser and you'll come back to the previous window. Now let's go ahead and enter Vaunda's chart of accounts with these names corresponding to these types. And again, leave your cap locks on so we can distinguish between the accounts that we put and the accounts that QuickBooks Online put. Now it's very easy. Notice there's only a few accounts left. You go to the top right in the chart of accounts window and you click new. Now when you get the new account window, you must remember to choose the type before the name. Cash in bank. If you put the name and then choose the type, the name will disappear, or the name will change back to the name that QuickBooks decides. Now I already have save and new. You have save and close here. Okay, but if you have save and close, you should change this to save and new so you can put in several at once. Okay, now again, the next one is accounts receivable type, and the name is all capitals, accounts receivable. And accounts receivable type will be explained in a few short videos coming up when we do the customer section. Save and new. So now what's the third account? Supplies, and it's another current asset. So first we choose other, well, I don't want to choose other asset. I'd like to choose other current asset, if possible. I see other current liabilities. Oh, here it is, other current asset, choose the type, and then type in supplies. Now click save and new. Now, if you leave this window for a moment, you can see that it's putting our accounts in the chart of accounts, cash and bank, accounts receivable and supplies. These that are in capitals are the ones that we just added. And you can see the corresponding type. And again, don't worry about the detail type until you get to a more advanced situation. Click new. Now, the type of the next one is a fixed asset, and the name is equipment. Save and new. There's only a few more to put in. Accounts payable is the name and the type, but remember, choose the type first, then type in the name. Save and new. Okay, very good. What else do we have? Video income and editing income are both income type of accounts. So we scroll down here to income, type in video income, save and new. Okay, go back to income, type in editing income, save and new. Now the rest I happen to remember are all expenses. So let's find out what expenses Vonda has. Delivery, electric, repair, and telephone. Delivery expense. Save and new. You have to change it back to expense every time. Repair expense. Save and new. Choose expense. Electric expense. Oops. And one more. Telephone expense. Save and new. Or you could click save and close if it's the last one. And here is your chart of accounts enhanced with additional accounts that QuickBooks Online requires. And the one thing I'd like to show before I close, if you click this cog in the chart of accounts window, you have the option of including the inactive accounts. Those are the ones that you try to delete. And notice there are many more on the list now, because when you try to delete an account, it makes it inactive. You could even take one of the ones that have already been deleted and click Make Active, and you'll see advertising and marketing are now active. Now, if you go back to the cog and tell QuickBooks, do not include inactive by removing the check mark, you'll see that that expense, advertising and marketing, is still here because we reactivated it just now. And that's how you manage your chart of accounts. You could always change the name by editing the account. For example, instead of cash and bank, you might want to change it to cash and Chase Bank. Any account on the list you can edit by clicking here, click edit, and then you put just, you know, change the text right here, cash in Chase Bank. And then you can click save and close. And now you change the name to Cash and Chase Bank. So you can add, delete, inactive, make active, or edit, all from this window, the chart of accounts.